St. Peter's. It is Phil Jamieson and Jim Murray at the guards. John Krutula, 6'5", at center. And the forwards, Tommy Best, who does a good job on the boards, and the 6'3", Shelton Gibbs. For the Fordham Rams, up front, it is David Maxwell and Mike Cooper. The center, 6'5", Dave Roberson. Mark Murphy and Tony McIntosh, the guards. Fordham in white, St. Peter's in blue, and we are underway. The semifinals. Fordham finished second in the conference, record of 7-3. St. Peter's also 7-3. And the first shot of the game is missed by Cooper, and here comes St. Peter's. This is Jamieson. And he sets it up. Jim Murray, number 32, Jamieson, number 10. Fordham in the man-to-man defense. Krutula's outside, Best working in a low post. They'll try to get the ball to Best and Gibbs. Best coming up a 24-point performance against Fairfield. St. Peter's had to play a first-round game. There's Best. Nice move, but he missed it. Follow is no good. Best tries again and makes it.
Tommy Best kept it alive. Both teams in a man-for-man, and we've got a little cleanup detail here.
The streamers come flying out for the first basket for St. Peter's. St. Peter's, having lost to Fordham twice, had to play a first round of the tournament and beat Fairfield 70-67. There is Bob Duquette. What an outstanding job he has done. 4 years head coach at St. Peter's.
A very subdued Bob Duquette.
81-30 in 4 years. What a record.
Well, it earned him a long-term contract. He and Jim Valvano, I guess, have the longest-term contracts around. Valvano out 10 years. He'll have a chance to open up pizza parlors all around North Carolina.
St. Peter's in a man-to-man is Tony McIntosh out of Randolph, New Jersey. Number 11 brings it up.
Very aggressive.
Coming outside.
Very aggressive man-for-man by St. Peter's, and they're not a terribly deep team. I don't think we'll see this for an extended period, but it's a great way to get your team started.
Jim Cartato and Larry Lembo are the officials. Cartato making the call, a foul on Jim Murray. There's Jim Murray, number 32. He is a sophomore out of Middletown, New Jersey.
The Metro Atlantic, one of the few conferences that they're not using three officials.
No shot clock, no three-point shot in this conference.
It's what you call pure. Everybody's going to be playing that very shortly. That is the official rule. Everything else this year has been in the form of experiment.
Krutula's almost stole it. Roberson had it blocked, gets it back, and misses. Best leaping. Loose ball scramble, and we'll jump it up. The arrow points in St. Peter's direction.
Nobody could get a fork in that one. Both of these teams, a lot of adrenaline out there.
Well, again, St. Peter's an outstanding record. Lost four games all year, as Bruce Beck mentioned, to Arkansas, one to Iona, and two to Fordham.
And they had Arkansas on the ropes here.
Yes, they did.
Sheldon Gibbs had a chance to win the game for him after he had carried him all night.
Fordham on the steal. The lead is to McIntosh, to the hoop, and missed it. Tommy Best the rebound, St. Peter's. The Peacocks leading 2-0, push it up. Jim Murray pulls up. Outside, Phil Jamieson. Nice shot. Jamieson doesn't shoot all that much.
I thought that was a little bit beyond his range when he let it go. Well, that sure got Duquette's blood boiling. Now the coat is off. We'll watch the tie go down and the shirt come undone.
4-0. St. Peter's leading it. Maxwell against Jamieson. Fakes it, goes in, forced it, missed it. Again a scramble. Again a jump ball. This time the arrow in Fordham's direction.
Boy, the intensity out there. These are not big teams, but I guarantee you that's a very physical board game right now. Both ends of the floor. Maxwell, the baby Dantley moves, the pump fakes. Excellent body control. Takes his body into you, makes you foul him.
Maxwell on the drive again. Pass Jamieson, puts it in. Oh. Strong move by David Maxwell. And this time the Fordham. Well, they don't have the streamers. They just have the litter.
Most of their alumni are in Wall Street. That was a ticker tape parade.
There's Tom Penders, fifth year as head coach at Fordham, and comes up with back-to-back winning seasons. Last year, 18-11. This year, 17-10. He's had three winning seasons out of five at Fordham.
Two straight NITs, hoping this year for the NCAA, but definitely a tournament team.
Long lead pass stolen by Maxwell.
You never throw the long one short. If you're going to do anything, throw it long.
McIntosh with a pretty move to the hoop, got fouled. John Krutulis gets off the floor. He committed the foul. And to the foul line will go Tony McIntosh.
Here's your good support defense now. Krutulis will take his stand, take his punishment. No question, he is allowed to extend his arms in a vertical plane. He's even allowed to jump in a vertical plane. No question, the offense went right into him. I think that was a poor call.
McIntosh hits his first. Fordham within one, 4-3, St. Peter's leading it. McIntosh is a sophomore out of Randolph, New Jersey, went to Randolph High School, and coming into his own as the point guard for Fordham.
I really would like to see them change that rule that if an offensive player charges, it doesn't matter. There can be no field goal.
Try to break the press. Gibbs saved it. See Fordham pressing all over the court. This is Jamison, now Shelton Gibbs. Tied at four.
Maxwell, in addition to being the offensive threat, is trying to put the collar on Sheldon Gibbs. 32 in the white, guarding 24 in the blue. The aces are matched up.
And he did do a fine job in a previous meeting between these two teams against Gibbs. Nice fake by Murray. Uses the glass and misses. Rebound McIntosh.
I don't imagine Sheldon Gibbs looks forward to playing against David Maxwell. Sheldon is not what you call a physical player. He'd like to play this game in a tuxedo. Slender, quick, soft, and Maxwell's a banger. Nice
Maxwell
pass.
Fires it for Roberson out of his hands. Best pushes it up. Gibbs to the hoop and scores and gets fouled on the play. Pretty move by Shelton Gibbs. And David Maxwell can't believe it, but he drew the foul.
Good coaching point for young players. David Maxwell was in pretty good shape not to really block that shot. Now watch, he reaches across with the right hand. If you reach with the inside hand or the hand closest to the rim, in this case the left, he wouldn't have fouled. But you see, he reached with the outside, the right hand, which brought his body into play.
Foul shot is missed. St. Peter's leading 6-4, 16 minutes to go in the first half.
Fordham going with a 1-4 offense against the man-for-man pressure defense. Hoping to get the back doors, hoping to isolate David Maxwell underneath.
And Krutulis takes the ball away from Roberson. Jamison looks to the bench for a little instruction from Bob Duquette. Down low, it's Tommy Best. Surrounded, pushes it out. Jamison hits again from outside.
Well, that's a big key for St. Peter's. Normally, it's Best and Gibbs are 75% of this attack, and already they're getting some good range shooting from Jamison. Look at Tommy Best come from all the way on the weak side.
I'll good tell hustle.
You, so far, the story of this game is St. Peter's man-for-man defense. They dominated.
There is timeout on the floor, 15:21 to go in the first half. The score, the Peacocks of St. Peter's 8, the Rams of Fordham 4.
This Bud's for everyone who's got the heart and courage to go the distance. Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser. This Bud's for you.
Bonjour, I work for the number one airline to Europe, TWA.
And we've got low fares to more cities in Europe than anybody.
This summer, London's just $5.49 round trip, over $200 less than last year. Paris, just $5.99. Rome, just $6.99.
So for low fares to my city...
And my city.
And the most cities in Europe, fly TWA.
Cheers. You're gonna like us, TWA.
This program is authorized by Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event, including the imposition of a charge for viewing the program without the express written consent of Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated, is prohibited. St. Peter's 8, Fordham 4, 15:21 to go. First half, Sam Rosen, Bucky Waters, and Bruce Beck at the Byrne Meadowlands Arena. Fordham trying to get the ball in. No substitutions. Neither team is too deep, Bucky. They'll go about seven, eight men.
Of course, St. Peter's had their famed thin bench of last year. Had a couple of defections and struggled a little bit earlier this year. However, both coaches by this time have really settled on the top seven. But you're absolutely right. This is not a deep team, and that was a kick.
Murray the steal. Gibbs on the three-on-one strip beautifully by Tony McIntosh. Fordham pushes it back. This is Murphy. And he makes it. Good shooting senior, Mark Murphy. Makes it 8-6, St. Peter's. That's a big turnaround. Good steal by McIntosh.
Murphy, one of those shooters that doesn't shoot well off the dribble. Very good going straight up, and he had plenty of time.
On the drive, it's John Kratulis. Giving St. Peter's a 10-6 lead. Fordham is shooting 2-for-7 for the floor. St. Peter's 5-for-8 thus far.
Yes, but I think it's the St. Peter's defense that's been the factor in the game. They're creating a lot of things.
Outside, it's Murphy again. So Mark Murphy, who started off slowly this year, has really gotten his game together the last five. He scored in double figures four of the last five games and is shooting 50% from the floor. 10-8, St. Peter's leading it. 14-15 to go, first half. Second game, Ionan Army. Down low, Gibbs, knocked away by Cooper. Here comes McIntosh. To Murphy, takes the outsider again and makes it three in a row for Murphy.
And he's not doing it against a passive zone. He's doing it as a pretty tough man for man by St. Peter's. Actually, it's the transition game, though. All of Murphy's shots were taken in transition when St. Peter's really wasn't dug in their half-court defense.
Tied at 10. Murphy has 6 points. Down low, Tommy Best has it knocked away by Maxwell. Good defense for Fordham. Roberson ahead of the field, saves it in. This is Maxwell. Got it up and in.
Boy, after that last timeout, Tom Pender's team came in and ran off four straight field goals. Bob Duquette, jacket back on, doing a little officiating.
Fordham with a lead, 12-10. This is Murray going in all the way, lays it off to Best. He's fouled by Cooper. Tommy Best will go to the line. Mike Cooper, the senior forward from the Bronx, fouled him. And we have our first substitution. Fordham sending in number 44, Don McCormick, and number 15, Jerry Hobby. Hobby is a sophomore from Elizabeth, New Jersey. Went to St. Patrick's High School. Tommy Best, the transfer from Lafayette.
Tom Pender, the Fordham coach, talking before the game, he said, well, depending on how they match up, so we may go to our big team. Our big team is McCormick and Roberson, et cetera. He said our big team goes 6'5", 6'5", 6'4", across the front. Of course, Ed Bona, a victim of hepatitis, a big blow to the Fordham program, expected to have a sensational year at 6'8". Their only real big man. He wasn't even a center, but he gave him some size defensively, as really a fine forward. It's a shame his senior year was virtually wiped out.
This is Maxwell going strong to the hoop, rejected by Tommy Best. Good block. Outside it's McIntosh. Missed it. Foul underneath. And it's on Fordham. Number 44, Don McCormick. The freshman out of Glen Ridge, New Jersey. Committed the foul. Just under 13 minutes to go. First half. St. Peter's and Fordham tied at 12. And St. Peter's breaking the pressure. This is Shelton Gibbs. Drops it off to Murray. And Murray missed it. Rebound. Battle is taken down by Fordham. Hobby drops it off to McIntosh. Bodies go flying. Bob Duquette wanted a foul. Underneath Maxwell, knocked away by Gibbs. Maxwell gets it back. Tied at 12. These two teams play tough matchups. They met at Madison Square Garden with Fordham winning by 4 points.
And it was closer than that. It was done at the free throw line. Some great club shooting by the Rams.
Fordham won at St. Peter's by 15 early in the season as well. McIntosh, the sophomore, guarded by Murray. Here's Maxwell. That's their best play, but Maxwell missed it. Cooper on the follow. Mike Cooper, senior from DeWitt Clinton High School, gives Fordham the 2-point lead.
Took his time, put a good fake on and went away. Used the rim to protect because there aren't too many rejectors in this game. You really don't have to be that concerned.
And McIntosh steals from Jamison and lays it in. Tony McIntosh having a fine game. He's got good, quick hands, Buck.
Well, you would think both of these teams wouldn't have much trouble with the press because, as we pointed out, they're small and basically guard small forward types. But I'll tell you, Fordham plays that tough pressure down the floor.
Fordham with its biggest lead, 4. Gibbs was blocked. Fordham in the man-to-man. Murray drops it off to Kratulis. A bit of a set shot there. One-hand set. No problem. 16-14, Fordham by 2. 11 minutes to go in the first half. Second game, Iona, number 1 in the conference. And defending MAC champions going against Army. Army got into the semifinals by beating Manhattan. 74-69.
St. Peter's showing a wrinkle now, going with the 1-2-2 zone. I really didn't think they had the depth to keep up with that defensive intensity, but it looked awfully good. Don't be surprised if we see them go back to that man-for-man very quickly. It usually isn't as effective the second time.
Hobby missed the outside shot and then fouled Murray. On the follow, Fordham not a real good outside shooting team. They'll stay with their game for the most part, trying to get the ball down low to Maxwell and Cooper, but Hobby took the outside shot and missed it. 10:31 to go in this first half from the Burn Meadowlands Arena. This is college basketball.
Hey, Fred.
Huh?
It's time for you to be on TV, Fred.
TV?
You got this great store. No customers. You got to advertise.
I do. Newspapers.
They can't hear it.
So I got radio.
They can't see it. Cable TV, Fred.
TV.
Cable TV. Cost about the same as radio. And the people watching me, could be watching you.
Call Cable Networks at 212-883-5696 for more information.
Yeah, no, that's fine. What you give me? Meadowlands Arena, St. Peter's and Fordham in a close one. 10:31 to go in the first half. Fordham leading at 16-14. Fordham shooting 7-for-16 from the floor. St. Peter's 6-for-11. Each team with 5 turnovers.
Well, this one is advertised. Sheldon Gibbs not having a great time. David Maxwell again banging, pushing, a physical player on a finesse player. St. Peter's trying to work the downside picks, trying to create some freedom. So far, David Maxwell has been an offensive leader and has done a remarkable job of holding Gibbs in check.
In the game at Madison Square Garden, Maxwell held Gibbs to just 10 points. St. Peter's, Jim Murray, ties it at 16.
St. Peter's staying with the zone.
Fordham going with Hobby and Murphy. Now Murphy's the shooting guard. This is the guy they'll give the ball to and to try and break the zone. Murphy number 10, Hobby number 15. Maxwell, Roberson, and McCormick, the front line. 6'5", 6'5", and 6'2". There's Murphy. He's hit 4 in a row.
Again, no dribble, straight up, a la Chris Mullen of St. John's. He does not, of course, have the range of Chris Mullen, but similar shooting styles.
Correction on Murphy's stats. He's 4-for-5. Look at that steal by Hobby. Here's Murphy coming down. Gives it over to Roberson, the big guy. Puts it in. Fordham goes up by 4. The Rams' biggest lead, 20-16.
As I discussed, St. Peter's defense early making the difference and being the catalyst. It is now Fordham's pressure defense that has put him on this hot streak.
Rotulas, Jamison outside. Missed. Rebound underneath Gibbs. He's fouled. Shelton Gibbs getting good position. He's only 6'3".
It's a quick leaper though, Sam. He's got one of those, got a pair of those springy legs. Gets right up there while everybody else is getting ready to coil. He's up and back.
Shelton Gibbs, who had a great freshman year last year, just followed it up with another outstanding season. He was all conference last year. And this year, another great year, averaging better than 19 points a game. and better than four rebounds a game. Fordham brings back Tony McIntosh, and David Maxwell sits down. And again, the three guards in there, Murphy, and Hobby, and McIntosh.
Well, against the 1-2-2 zone, Maxwell's absence isn't that critical offensively. The key will be what they do with Sheldon Gibbs. Maxwell did a good job on him defensively. We'll have to check out, see perhaps if Tom Penders elects to go zone or give the contract on Gibbs to someone else.
Fordham by three. Murray almost stole from McIntosh.
Most teams attack to the right side. If Fordham is smart, they'll attack to the left, and I'll explain why in a minute.
Murphy missed. Rebound McCormick. He's double-teamed. Krutulis knocked it away. Here's Murray with Gibbs ahead of him. Slows it down, waits for help. St. Peter's trails by three. 8:40 to go in the first half. Down low, Shelton Gibbs puts it up. He forced it. Foul on the rebound. Call it on McCormick of Fordham. Shelton Gibbs went 1-on-3 and got away with it.
Yeah, but he's so happy he didn't have to climb over David Maxwell. He's got renewed energy. As we go back to the other end after this, on the next possession by Fordham.
The inbounds to Krutulis.
We'll talk about that 1-2-2 and why it's better to attack it from the left.
Fordham with 16 fouls. This is Shelton Gibbs. Stolen away, foul called. And it's on Gibbs. That was a frustration foul. That Hobby is a tough player, number 15, Jerry Hobby. There's Tom Penders.
Well, it was Jerry Hobby that iced the win in Madison Square Garden. Sensational clutch free throw shooter. And it wasn't a surprise. They
Murphy.
Count on him.
Murphy will inbound.
Okay, let's look at that 1-2-2. Tommy Best, the team's best rebounder, is down on the left side as you face the basket. By attacking from the left side, you bring him off the board, and you get the best rebounder out there guarding a shooter, and leaving Krutulis as the strong man underneath, the decided advantage if you want an offensive rebound.
Krutulis knocked it away from McCormick, and St. Peter's comes down, trailing by three. Phil Jamison. Jamison hit a couple of shots early and has missed his last one. Fordham with seven turnovers now as Tommy Best lays it in. Tommy Best, whose shooting percentage from the floor is 66%, or rather 65%, and that's the reason why.
Well, a miraculous part of that play was his body control and, first of all, making the catch in traffic. It was a good pass, but there was almost no room in the end. He really had a wiggle. Once he got it up on the board soft, it was easy to see why he's a good percentage shooter.
That time they called Hobby for traveling. 20-19, Fordham leading it by one. With 7:38 to go, Tom Penders can't believe it. And we have a timeout on the floor. 7:38 to go, first half of our first semifinal, and we'll be right back.
Manufacturers Hanover, we make the facts work for you. That's why you're coming to us for the facts on savings. Facts on credit needs. You're also calling our special fact phones, using our fact coupons and fact sheets, attending our free fact seminars. You're even getting the facts and cash from our MHT 24-hour banking centers. So keep coming to Manufacturers Hanover Trust, where our facts make your money worth more.
Look where the facts got us.
It's ColecoVision's new driving module with Sega's Turbo. The video controller looks and plays just like the arcade game. Changing roads. Through tunnels. Oil slick. Race Turbo on your ColecoVision, Atari VCS, or Intellivision game systems.
Make plans now to be on hand when NCAA college basketball returns to the Meadowlands for its third season. Next year's schedule will feature the first and second rounds of the NCAA Eastern Regional, plus exciting national matchups and all the local favorites. For season ticket information, write College Basketball, Post Office Box 512, East Rutherford, New Jersey, or call 201-935-3900 for details on next season's college basketball schedule here at the Byrne Meadowlands Arena. And want to thank all the fine people here at the Meadowlands Arena for all their help this season in bringing college basketball to you on Madison Square Garden Cablevision. It's been a pleasure working here, and we hope to be working with the arena people next season as well. Tommy Best inside, ball for traveling.
Boy, the Fordham defense really makes the inside game difficult. They don't have any rejectors. They just jam it up with quickness and bodies, and they're not afraid to take the charge. The perimeter passers, St. Peter's has to be very cautious when they make the entry pass that they don't get the receiver in trouble because there's no place to go. Excellent defense by the Rams.
Both teams with 8 turnovers. Murphy around to Hobby, outside again. Maxwell has been sitting down a long time for Fordham. That ball is saved nicely by Murphy. Hobby in trouble, just bust through like a fullback coming through the line, then lost it to Gratulis. This is Murray. Shelton Gibbs up and around and out. The rebound, McIntosh. Gibbs a little too hard off the glass. Look at this scramble. Bodies flying, foul call.
Wow. What that was, folks, was what you call basic aggressive. It wasn't pretty.
Shelton Gibbs called on the foul. Fourth team foul for St. Peter's. Fordham has 6. 9 turnovers for Fordham. St. Peter's shooting 8-for-16 from the floor. Fordham 9-for-19. McIntosh with 8 points leading Fordham. Tommy Best 6 points and 3 rebounds leading St. Peter's. McIntosh off the front. Roberson couldn't control the rebound. Knocked out of bounds. It's St. Peter's ball. Good hustle. Jim Murray.
It's not pretty. It's a long way from textbook, but the effort is certainly there. This is the season. When you get to March, there's no place for the faint-hearted.
St. Peter's has not gone to the bench at all thus far in the first half. Foul called down low. It's on Mike McCormick. And that'll bring 1-1 at the line for St. Peter's as Fordham goes over the limit.
Even the loser in this game will play again. There are tournament teams. They're both playing as though this was the last cast.
The winner of the tournament does not get an automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. Next year, the winner of the tournament will get the automatic bid. LaSalle and Holy Cross will join the MAC conference next year. This year, of course, Iona, with a fine record and a fine national schedule, is hoping to get a bid. Fordham, who plays a pretty tough schedule as well, feels they have an outside shot for an NCAA bid if they can win the tournament.
I think it's not wishful thinking. I think they deserve it.
Tommy Best, 2 foul shots, gives him 8 points. He's having a good ball game. Played a fine game against Fairfield Monday night when St. Peter's beat Fairfield in the first round of the tournament. McIntosh looking at the 1-2-2 zone put up by St. Peter's. Maxwell is back in for Fordham. Steal by Jamison. McIntosh chases. Jamison rejected but fouled. Did McIntosh sky for that one?
Well, that's one of those frustrations. You get stripped right out there in the midcourt area. You get renewed energy. It was a good foul. Jamison has to clear his head. He got it clean, no question. McIntosh, Tony McIntosh, the 6'2 sophomore from Randolph, New Jersey, said, "No chance, pal. You're going to have to get those two from 15 feet away, one at a time."
Bill Jamison will go to the line. Jamison was a walk-on 2 years ago. And now he runs the offense for the Peacocks of St. Peter's. He's a junior, 6'1", 175 out of Jersey City. Shooting 2, and St. Peter's has regained the lead with 6 straight points, 22-20. Jamison averaging 10 points a game. Hits again, and it's a 3-point St. Peter's lead, just under 6 minutes to go. Jamison now has 6.
One of his better games, however, was against Iona in the big game last year with 18, so he maybe likes to play a little better scoring-wise under pressure.
Roberson in the lane, missed it, and the foul called. It's on St. Peter's. Jamison raises his hand. It may have been on Shelton Gibbs. It was on Shelton Gibbs. Jamison had the hand up saying it was me, but it's called on Shelton Gibbs, and that is his 3rd.
Well, that's called protecting the franchise.
And that is trouble for St. Peter's. Here goes Roberson to the hoop, and he gets it, fouled by Tommy Best on the play.
Tommy Best forgot that Roberson was left-handed. He went toward that baseline shoulder. Excellent body control. Watch Roberson now ease inside Again, best coming baseline. Most of the time, his move is to protect the baseline, except when you got a left-hander. And he just eased around, gently used that free arm, that right arm, to create a little room. Looks like a tight end, man.
Dave Roberson, he's moved into the middle in place of Ed Bona. Anthony Green, number 34, is into the game for St. Peter's. He replaces Shelton Gibbs. Gibbs sitting down with three personal fouls and only 5 points. Score tied at 23. As Roberson with that soft touch, the big bounce on the foul shot. Down low for Best, and he's fouled. And this looks like it'll be on Maxwell of Fordham.
And that'll be his third.
It'll be one and one on the line for Tommy Best.
The foul is on Maxwell, but this was nearly a charge on Best. It was a good call because that, when Best left the floor, Maxwell had not established himself, but that's a dangerous pass. This is the point I made earlier about the player making the entry pass from the perimeter has got to be more aware of that weak side defense. There's just no room to come down in there.
Tommy Best misses. He had been 4 for 4 from the line. Tied at 23, 5:20 to go. First half. First semifinal, Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference Tournament.
Both top guns are out now, Maxwell and Gibbs. The Chiefs are down, then the Indians have to decide it.
Talk about a test of strength and stamina. This is McCormick missing, rebound, batted around, it's Jameson. The championship is tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock. So not too much rest for the winners tonight.
Yeah, but when you're playing for your conference championship, you think about getting tired later.
Foul underneath is Roberson. Larry Lembo makes the call.
It appears, Sam, that both officials look a little concerned with the rough play. I think they might have had a little conversation and said, hey, we better get this thing cleaned up. They're really banging. The last couple of fouls have been rather gentle. It looks to me like a game plan to get things under control. How tough is it in there? Tough man for man by Fordham. Excellent move. Get on the baseline side. McIntosh playing tough on the ball.
Oh. Roberson, a little shoving on Green.
He just,
Green shoves him back.
Yeah, that's called friendly inside play. Get a tetanus shot and come.
Junior Anthony Green at the line for the 1-1 makes both St. Peter's back on top by 2. 4:45 left first half. Tommy Best far away from the basket, moving underneath to Kurtulis and Green. Long shot by Murphy, would not go. Kurtulis the rebound. Both teams have their leading scorers sitting down. Anthony Green has it in the corner, outside Kurtulis. David Maxwell and Shelton Gibbs. Maxwell for Fordham, Shelton Gibbs for St. Peter's. Sitting down with three personal fouls. Petulis could not save it. Lost it out of bounds. It's Fordham ball. The Rams send Jerry Hobby back in. And we're going to take a timeout with 4 minutes and 5 seconds to go in this first half. St. Peter's 25, Fordham 23. You're watching college basketball on Madison Square Garden Cablevision. We'll be right back. Sam Rosen, along with the man you most like to watch college basketball with, Bucky Waters and Bruce Beck at the Burn Meadowlands Arena. Hope you're enjoying tournament time in the MAC Conference, with St. Peter's leading Fordham 25-23. Second game brings Iona, number one in the conference in the regular season, 8-2 against Army, team that finished tied for last place, but coming on strong and playing a lot better late in the season, and will be no pushover for Iona.
No, they're one of those teams that come in here tonight. Army coming over that Cinderella win over Manhattan. Of course, it was a Manhattan team with lots of injury problems, but all you have to do is look at the scores from the middle of the season on, and you can see that Army was a different team. So they're coming in here tonight very loose, everything to gain, nothing to lose. Iona has the pressure on them. Iona also has a much better team.
Down low, it's Cooper, again knocked away, saved it. McIntosh, in and out. Cooper, the follow, got it in nicely. Strong play underneath by 6'4", Mike Cooper.
He got hammered pretty good on several occasions and probably had a turnover. I thought he carried that one.
Tied at 25. Fordham shooting 11 of 26 from the floor. Outside. Jamison getting across to Kratulis. Now Fordham in the zone defense. Foul underneath. It's on St. Peter's. Looks like Anthony Green.
Bob Duquette goes to Anthony Green when he wants a bigger, more physical lineup. That time, Anthony Green trying to create a little more room for himself in the post. That was a good call. Again, that banging and bumping inside has both officials concerned.
St. Peter's has gone over the limit in fouls, and it'll be Dave Roberson at the line, shooting 1-1. Roberson, a junior from Pittsburgh, New York, goes 6'5". Roberson has 5 points. He's a 55% foul shooter and misses. Jamison rebounds. St. Peter's has played just 6 men in his first half. Fordham, 7. Neither team a deep bench. Kratulis. Tommy Best goes outside. Shelton Gibbs, leading scorer for St. Peter, sitting down with 3 personals. Best with a strong move, called on an offensive foul.
Bob Duquette is livid all the way to midcourt.
There you see Bob Duquette. And Duquette got hit with a technical. I think he went past the line, Bucky.
I would say this, that in the East, the coaches, if you can read lips, you don't have any difficulty knowing just how Bob Duquette feels, A, about the call, and B, about the technical. But I would say that the officials in the East are the most lenient with regard to the coaches going beyond that magic line and getting up even across half court. It just seems to be acceptable as long as they're not berating the officials. Bob Duquette was not only in the midcourt, he unloaded verbally on whomever would listen, and the guys in the striped shirts took it personally.
Jerry Hobby, who's better than 80% from the line, missed the first and made the second of the 2 technical fouls.
Well, this is not a great time to get a technical, right before the half that way. And I don't think it was with any intent to turn his team around or whatever. I think Bob Duquette just lost his cool a little bit and what he thought was a bad call.
You saw him take 3 foul shots. The first foul shot was the first end of the 1-1, and he missed. Then he shot the 2 technicals and made both. And Fordham goes up by 2, 27-25, just under 3 minutes to go.
Well, let's see what they do with the gratis possession. Interesting move here with a 2-point lead. Fordham is going to pull St. Peter's out of the zone. Remember now, they only have to be warned once, the team behind, once each half.
Roberson to Hobby.
This is exactly what Fordham did to Notre Dame when they carved them up in here. They spread the bigger, slower Irish out and did an outstanding job of controlling the tempo of the game.
Fordham leading by 2.
Digger Phelps went from that loss right down to North Carolina State and won in Raleigh.
Hobby up in the air, missed it. Cooper the follow, good, the foul. Cooper's done a great job underneath.
Well, Tom Pender's counter to the bigger, stronger St. Peter's lineup with the three big men. Here we see the open floor. A good wiggle inside. A little half hitch there, not a great touch. Good pump fake. Shows the ball, keeps his feet on the floor. It rains blue jerseys. Missed the opportunity to convert.
Fordham by four. Lead has never been bigger than 4 points for either team. This is Phil Jamieson, Jim Murray working the backcourt for St. Peter's. 29-25, 2 minutes to go first half.
Fordham now going zone.
Jamieson missed it. Kratulis a big rebound. Over the back of Hobby, and then he walked for the ball.
Kratulis really did go to go over Hobby's back on that one. That wasn't a call. Larry Lembo did get the walk. I would have to think that officials who are used to working in threes would really have a serious adjustment, getting used to working with two. The coverage is drastic in its difference, and I can understand some miscoverage.
McIntosh, the cross-court bounce pass, is knocked out of bounds by Jamieson. A minute 32 to go in this first half.
St. Peter's has to come out and get him. If not all out, at least tokenly.
Jamieson tried to draw an offensive foul on the inbound. Good pressure by St. Peter's. A minute 20 to go in the first half. Fordham by four.
Instead of going man for man, St. Peter's now in a half-court trap, 2-2-1.
McIntosh against Best. McIntosh the follow. With Anthony Green sitting on his backside in the lane. After the collision, it's a 6-point Fordham lead.
A high post, of course, is the weakness in that half-court trap. Fordham went right to it, and with the guard in the middle, it's especially dangerous. He's a triple threater.
Green over Roberson, missed it. Kratulis with a nice soft follow. Nice tip in by John Kratulis, the senior from Linden, New Jersey. 31-27, Fordham by four with 35 seconds to go in the first half. Kratulis third offensive rebound with that tip in. Here's Hobby. Murray fouls him. And Hobby is the guy that Fordham wants at the line as much as possible. He is a better than 80% foul shooter. And Fordham will bring in its big guy from Yugoslavia, freshman Goran Skoko.
Well, obviously here with the foul situation there at Fordham, especially with the best inside player, David Maxwell, having three, it's pretty obvious to me Tom Penders is trying to get Goran Skoko in the game, if for only 29 seconds, at least get him baptized in the first half. He's probably going to need him in the second half at the rate the fouls are being called.
Hobby hits again. He's now hit three in a row after missing his first.
Skoko played a very solid game against Notre Dame.
Yes, he did.
Of course, the South Bend bulk, the big ponderous Notre Dame front line, he was right at home. St. Peter's a little quicker, a little leaner.
Hobby makes both. Fordham back up by 6-33-27. St. Peter's has not been able to solve the mystery of how to beat the Fordham Rams this season.
Fordham showing yet another defense. Now 2-3 with Skoko in the middle.
Skoko is 6'10". Tom Penders feels he'll be a contributor.
He's never going to be a rejector. He's going to be one of those solid people, space eater.
5 seconds and a half. Kratulis missed his set shot. Rebound McIntosh. Lead to Cooper. Can't save it. That'll do it for the first half. And Cooper runs up into the 10th row. Wanted to check out the concession stand up there. Didn't like the popcorn and came back to the game.
Good thing there was an aisle there. He'd have been wearing some folks.
Well, first half of basketball again. The Fordham Rams lead it at halftime 33-27. We'll be back in just a moment.
Vitalis says it's true. A man has to keep himself under control.
4,000 feet, 3,000 feet, 2,000 feet.
But I'm under control.
After you dry and style your hair, use the Vitalis pump for a terrific natural look you can keep under control just the way you want all day long.
My horse in the fifth finished first in the sixth. But I'm under control.
Who says it's true? Vitalis says it's true. A man has to keep himself under control.
I'm under control.
Thank you. know me. You may know my do, wackadoo, 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 wackadoo. But my do, wackadoo don't do me no good when I'm traveling. So I just got myself an American Express card. And that makes me the king of the road.
To apply for the card, look for an application and take one.
The American Express card. Don't leave home without it.
I may be a professor of English, but sometimes I'm best understood when I speak German.
Beck's.
Beck's, the number one imported German beer.
33-27 at halftime, Fordham leads. With me is Pat Kennedy, head basketball coach for the Iona Gales, who in the nightcap will take on the Army Black Knights. And Pat, first of all, your thoughts of that first half. Fordham just seems to play St. Peter so tough.
You know, they really seem to have their number. I'm sure that Bobby Duquette would like to change that in the second half. But they play tenacious defense. They really play you very close. They do a great job of getting their hands on passes, and they create a lot of problems for you. And St. Peter's is a very patient and disciplined team, and they're a tough team to cause problems for. So you've got to credit Fordham's defense in the first half. They got a little spurt with Mark Murphy hitting three or four jump shots. And, of course, when you get down to playoff time, it's a turnover. It's a little spurt that can make the difference.
How about your ball game tonight? Army seems to always play the Iona Gales tough. And again tonight, you're matched up against the Black Knights. What are your thoughts on the game?
Well, you know, Army's come a long way, and Les Wittke, the new coach, has done a great job with them. They're not holding the ball as much as they used to, and they're really playing a nice style of good discipline ball without holding it. So they have been tough for us. They're excellent shooters. They shoot the ball very well on the perimeter. They've got an excellent player, Randy Cousins, could almost play anywhere in the country, and a real fine freshman, 6'7", Kenny Schwartz. So we're looking forward to a tough game. Our kids know what this game means. Every year, I've been here now for 6 years, every game we've had with Army's been a tough one. So when the game's over, though, you always know that our country's in good hands. That's the one thing that's good to know.
You know, I talked earlier tonight about Fordham and their schedule. Well, you play a pretty good schedule. You played Memphis State very tough. You beat Arizona State here at the Burn Meadowlands Arena. Do you feel that's the key ingredient in the success of this team?
Well, I think, you know, you've got to take a look at your schedule at the beginning of the year and say you're going to take a few lumps here and there, but you're going to be better as the season goes on. We've really prefaced our season on that. We have every season. We want a national as well as local schedule. The Marquettes, the Memphis States, the Arizona States really get you ready for some of the teams maybe of not that caliber, and hopefully your kids are going to, you know, learn from those games. But we have played a very difficult schedule. 20-7 at this point, we're extremely happy with that. We've lost two players to injuries and one to academic eligibility. So we're very pleased with where we are right now and really look forward to this weekend.
Well, you know, you talk about the Metro Atlantic Conference, and of course you talk about one of the newer coaches who has just joined us in the studio, Les Wittke, head basketball coach for the Army Black Knights. And Les, how do you feel about this ball game tonight?
Well, we're just excited to be here. You know, we finished tied for last in the conference in Manhattan, and we had two good ball games with Manhattan prior to the playoffs. And, you know, we felt if we could win it and get here, that would be quite an accomplishment for our program. So we're happy to be here. And it's our third shot at Iona, and we've failed twice, so maybe this is the lucky one.
Well, you may have failed twice, but I just spoke to Pat a moment ago, and he can attest that you do play them awfully tough.
Well, we've had two good ball games with them, but they've always managed to handle us pretty easily at the end of the games.
Gentlemen, let me ask you about the conference. The Metro Atlantic Conference in its second year has grown by leaps and bounds. First of all, Pat, your thoughts on how this conference has come to being, and is this really going to be one of the more competitive conferences in the future?
Well, I really believe so. I think when you get local schools, regional schools that have a tradition that's already been established against each other, you take the six that we have now, the tradition is fierce. You know, and you add teams of the likes of Holy Cross and LaSalle, two NCAA and NIT champions, and I think you have the makings of a great league. The media is very important, and we're in the media capital of the world, New York. We've got some great players. I think some kids are going to go on to play professional ball. And of course, if MSG Cable keeps putting us on, we're going to be in even better shape. So with the media capital and with the traditional rivalries, I think it's going to make for a great conference.
Les, your first year in the league, your impression?
Well, I've been very impressed with the conference. I think some excellent basketball, of course, played on the East Coast, which is all new to me, being a Midwesterner. But I think the league that we're in is excellent, just as Pat said. And I think the addition of Holy Cross and LaSalle is going to add a lot of exposure in those two areas of the country. And I think it's really an up-and-coming conference.
All right, let's get into specifics for tonight's ball game. And if you say something, the other coach will hear it, so let's not try to pull any punches. First of all, Pat Kennedy, head coach of Iona, how do you go about beating Army?
Well, I think the first thing you've got to do is stay out of foul trouble. They're the ninth leading free throw team in the country. Manhattan got in trouble by fouling them, and it hurt them late. Don't foul him. Try and stop Randy Cousins if you can. And, of course, for your own good, you've got to stay within your game plan.
Les Whitkey, how do you go about attacking a 20-win club in the Iona Gale?
We try to get him to foul us a lot so we get to the free throw line. No, we're going to, you know, we'll play him head up just like we have the first two times and just hope the ball goes in for us. There's, you know, we're not nearly as big as Iona, and that's going to be a problem for us. Coleman had just a super game against us, and Springer is so strong inside, and I think Burt might be one of the premier players in the country. So they've just got a very sound basketball team, and we're just going to come out and try to play some sound basketball against them.
Les, is this game all gravy for you? You only won five games last year. Of course, you weren't at Army, but now you come back with 10 wins. You defeat Manhattan in the early round of the Metro Atlantic Conference Tournament, and you're here tonight in a game that really must be must give you a lot of pride knowing that you're here.
Well, we're happy to be here, but, you know, we tell our players, when you walk in and smell the popcorn, it's game time. And we can't in any way, shape, or form be satisfied simply that we're here.
Pat, do you feel the pressure knowing that you've beaten this team twice already and now beating a team a third time is not easy?
Definitely not easy, yeah, especially a quality team. And, again, Army has 10 wins. They probably were a few points away from a few more wins, and that's quite an improvement over a year ago. They've got some kids who have been experienced now over the last few years and some fine young kids. It's hard to beat a good team three times. Our kids have been here. Hopefully our maturity is starting to surface, and of course we'll find out in the next, not even 24 hours, the next 16 hours, I think, so if we're fortunate enough to get by tonight. So they've got to come to play, and I think they realize that.
Gentlemen, final thoughts on this first game tonight. Les, who do you like, Fordham or St. Peter's, and why?
Well, I've gone with Fordham before the game started, not just the halftime score. I just like the way they play, and I think they've got the quickness and strength inside to match up with St. Peter's. When we played St. Peter's, both times they just jumped on us and really, really handled us the first 10 minutes of the game and put us away early, but we didn't have the quickness to go with them, and I think Fordham does, and I like Fordham all the way on it.
Pat, quickly, the key to the second half.
Well, I think that St. Peter's has got to come out and give them a little bit more pressure towards the half-court line. They've got good quickness. Jameson had a steal or two there. I think they've got to come out of their zone and go at you because they've got great quickness. I picked St. Pete's early only because I think it is difficult to beat a good club three times, and, of course, this is their third matchup.
Pat Kennedy, head coach of the Iona Gales. Les Whitkey, head coach of the Army Cadets. To both of you, good luck in the nightcap this evening.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
You.
The score here at the halftime of our first game, 33-27. Fordham leads St. Peter's, and you're watching college basketball on Madison Square Garden Cablevision.
Hi, I'm Martha Quinn from MTV Music Television. To celebrate the arrival of spring, we've got an exciting contest from MTV and Canada Dry brought to you by your cable system. You could be the lucky grand prize winner of two tickets and backstage passes to the Hall & Oates concert at Madison Square Garden on March 21st. Limousine service for the night, a Pioneer sound system, two cases of Canada Dry ginger ale, two H2O tour jackets like the one I've got on, and the complete RCA Records catalog of Hall & Oates albums, including their latest H2O, and an MTV sweatshirt, and, of course, the tour bag. Five second-place winners will receive two tickets to the concert, an MTV t-shirt and tour bag, and an H2O album. 10 third-prize winners will receive an Hall & Oates t-shirt. To enter, send a postcard with your name, address, age, and phone number to this address, and postcards must be received by midnight March 14th.
And welcome back to the Burn Meadowlands Arena. We're at halftime of our first semifinal, and the Rams of Fordham with a six-point lead. And Bucky, a lot of turnovers for both teams. Fordham has the six-point lead despite shooting a very poor 13 for 30 from the floor.
Yeah, but I thought their defense turned it around. We talked about St. Peter's pressure man for man early, and it really got them going. I thought an exceptional key to this first half, both of the stars got in foul trouble.
Right.
Maxwell down, Gibson down. So it went with the Chiefs out. The Indians had to do it. And I do think that Fordham is deeper and a little bit stronger. And I thought that that showed in the latter stages of the first half.
And some key play by the guards of Fordham. Murphy got the baskets early, hit four of his first five. McIntosh has had an outstanding first half.
Yes, again, that pressure defense of Fordham. We talked about St. Peter's. They like to play that Lawrence Welk tempo. Here, McIntosh gets a steal. This is a... outstanding defensive play. Number 11, McIntosh, strips him clean when it looked like he might have to foul to prevent the layup. He now turns, puts the ball on the floor, and he's going coast to coast. He's going to look up here in a minute, find Murphy for the easy pass. And this is one of the things that Fordham will do best. They are much better in transition. St. Peter's much better at the half-court game. The little soft touch by Murphy, the little 10-footer, and especially when St. Peter's went to zone, it was Murphy's outside shooting that was crucial. All right, when Fordham went zone, it was still aggressive. St. Peter's had a very difficult time finding the inside game. As we noted, Sheldon Gibbs with only 3 points. Part of that was foul trouble, but notice the movement inside now. A very physical Fordham defense.
And the way they denied Tommy Best the ball. With Gibbs out, St. Peter's has got to get the ball down to Tommy Best, and they couldn't do it.
And guess who's coming again? Number 11. I think it's Fordham's defense. They're a little bit deeper, and I thought they were very successful at spreading the floor. St. Peter's has to come out of that zone and come out and get him, Sam.
I think the other key is Shelton Gibbs has got to become a part of the offense and take command if St. Peter's has to have any hope of coming back and winning the game. Let's take a look at the first half statistics for both teams, and it looks like this. The shooting, as we mentioned, Fordham 13 for 29 officially, and St. Peter's is shooting 50% from the floor, keeping them in the game. Both teams with a lot of turnovers, St. Peter's with 12. The rebounding statistics are close. Foul shooting is close. Turnovers a big factor. St. Peter's 12. And again, Fordham, despite shooting 13 for 29, still doing quite well with the six-point lead. Taking a look at the high scores in the first half, St. Peter's, Tommy Best has 8. Jameson has 6. Kratulis has 6. And Shelton Gibbs, their leading scorer, who averages better than 19 a game, only 3 points in the first half. For Fordham, Murphy with 8 points. Cooper has 6. He's played a strong game inside. McIntosh with 6. And Roberson with 5. And there, too, David Maxwell in some foul trouble, sitting down with 3 personal fouls. He has only 4 points. So
Tom Penders has a decision. He knows that Maxwell can stop Gibbs, but does he want to risk the fourth foul early? It'd be interesting to see if he comes back out in pressure or goes zone to save Maxwell.
Okay, second half coming your way in just a moment. The score, Fordham 33, St. Peter's 27. We'll be back with the second half in just a moment.
Go where you've never been before. Achieve Mitsubishi.
In the Starion, the all-new sports car with Mitsubishi's own turbocharger for blast-off acceleration and a wind-slicing flush surface body design. Starion, the sports car that translates your will into performance, grace, and precision.
Mitsubishi takes you where you've never been before.
A perfect egg. Or is it? Magnified 20,000 times, you see imperfections you never knew existed. Look into a car's carburetor and you may see something you never knew existed. Dirt. Dirt that could impede your car's performance. Fortunately, you can wash dirt away before it accumulates with Mobil Detergent Gasoline. It treats dirt like dirt.
Oh. Oh.
Oh. Thank you, Payne Webber.
I like it. I love it. I'll take it. Thank you, Payne Webber.
In this highly competitive financial world, Payne Webber believes the quality of life just might depend on the quality of your investments.
This buzz for everyone who knows they've got what it takes to get the job.
This buzz for you, for all you do, the king of beers is coming. We'll be right back.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
Hey, this bud's for you.
Sam Rosen, Bucky Waters, and Bruce Beck at the Byrne Meadowlands Arena. We're getting set for the second half of our first semifinal. The Fordham Rams leading the Peacocks of St. Peter's 33-27. Second game matches Iona against Army in the championship tomorrow afternoon here at the Byrne Meadowlands Arena at 1 o'clock. St. Peter's will inbound to start the second half. And it is Murray and Jamison working the backcourt. Fordham coming out in a man-to-man. Down low, Tommy Best. Best against Cooper. Cooper with a great defensive play. And again, that Fordham defense.
Well, if you remember the start of the game, St. Peter's immediately went to Best down inside, and he responded. They never did find Gibbs.
And an offensive foul, Tony McIntosh.
In answer to our question, Pender's decision, he's coming back with his best defense, man for man.
The official first half statistics handed to us. St. Peter shooting 45%, and Fordham 43.3, 13 for 30.
Again, he has made one adjustment, though. Maxwell is playing Jamison instead of Gibbs.
And this time it's Cooper reaching over the back of Tommy Best, and you can see thus far, for St. Peter's, they've come out trying to get the ball into Tommy Best.
The defensive assignment on Sheldon Gibbs now has gone to Tony McIntosh, who had a sensational half at both ends of the floor. Problem being, McIntosh at 6'2 is giving away a little height to Sheldon Gibbs.
Cooper sits down with three personal fouls. He's replaced by Don McCormick. Number 44, St. Peter's gets the ball in. Murray. Murray number 32, Jamison number 10 are the guards. Murray against Murphy. This is Phil Jamison. Tommy Best, John Crotula, Shelton Gibbs up front for St. Peter's. Down low, Tommy Best. Now he's surrounded. Working outside. Shelton Gibbs is off. And here comes McIntosh, the sophomore. Close it up.
Smart move.
Murphy has 10 points. Just a little hitch, short shot, Mark Murphy has 10.
Tom Penders, I like the move. He stayed with his best defense, staying with the man for man, but by making the switch and taking Maxwell off of Gibbs.
Good move.
Along the line with the fine game that McIntosh has had all night. Watch now, he looks around. Scouts, he says, no way, too many blue jerseys, but I'll keep my dribble alive and I'll root around. And sure enough, he finds Mark Murphy on the baseline with a little double clutch and a nice soft jumper. That's the kind of leadership you need in the backcourt.
Sheldon Gibbs missed from the foul line. Gibbs off from the foul line tonight, 1 for 4. He now has 5 points after he hit that basket. 6 point Fordham lead, 35-29. A minute and a half gone by, second half.
Jamison's playing Maxwell, number 10, Jamison. This is a good matchup for Jamison out here. Where he has to worry is where Maxwell is going, which is to post up.
Ball knocked out of bounds. It is off Fordham's Roberson, and St. Peter's takes over.
I look for Fordham to take advantage of that matchup very quickly. I think we can look for Maxwell to post up with Jamison underneath. At the other end of the floor, Jamison's not a driver, he's a jump shooter. So the chances of Maxwell picking up that fourth foul have been reduced considerably. Smart matchup.
Murray. Gibbs set up side of the lane. Now comes outside, works off a pick from Murray, and hits. That's what the other aspect of the offense. Best down low, Gibbs outside. Shelton Gibbs has hit 2 for 3 in the second half, and he gets going offensively. St. Peter's trailing by 4. McIntosh for the ball against Murray. This is Murphy. McIntosh and Murphy, the guards. It's McIntosh hitting it. Nice shot from the corner by Tony McIntosh, who was 2 for 7 in the first half. And hits his first one to start here in the second half. He has 8 points.
Sophomore from Randolph, New Jersey is doing it.
He started shooting better this second half of the season.
Well, they've switched back now. Maxwell's returned to his original assignment on Sheldon Gibbs.
Gibbs on the turnaround, missed it. Maxwell the rebound. He's got Roberson with him. Goes in against Kratulis and makes it.
Oh, that's called hustling the ball in.
A one-man fast break. Oh.
There wasn't any question about where he was going. Stuck it right up his nose. Nearly had a chance for a three-point play.
6 points for Maxwell. Fordham by eight. 39-31. 16:45 to go. Second half. Shelton, make that. Phil Jamison outside.
Boy, didn't take him long to find a crease in that 1-3-1 zone. Fordham just doesn't look good in a zone. They're much better in their man-for-man, and Penders is trying to change up the look a little bit because his horse is in foul trouble, but they just don't play that zone anywhere as nearly effective as they do their man-for-man.
Here's Murphy against Shelton Gibbs. Murphy missed it. Rebound Gibbs. He leaps. This is Murray for St. Peter's. Peacock trail by six. Down low for Best. It's for the ball. Larry Lembo did not see it. And now they say, let's see. It is for the ball. They said no deflection. Bob Duquette said it was deflected by one of the Fordham players. The officials did not agree. Anthony Green is back in for St. Peter's, replacing John Kratulis. 12 turnovers for St. Peter's in the game. Maxwell, Murphy outside. Tough man-to-man for St. Peter's. Here comes McIntosh. Dish off to Roberson, who missed it. Anthony Green with a rebound. St. Peter's trailing by six.
Excellent penetration again by McIntosh. He put the ball right in Roberson's hand. Just missed the easy layup.
Fordham in the zone. Jamison the outside shot. Roberson couldn't get the rebound. Still loose. Maxwell controls. The senior, David Maxwell. Tony McIntosh, sophomore, averages better than seven a game. This is Murphy, the outside shooter. He's got 10 in the game. McIntosh hits it. Good shot by Tony McIntosh. He's hit his first two in the second half. Fordham shooting better in the second half. McIntosh has 10, Murphy has 10 to lead Fordham. 41-33, the Rams by eight. 14:30 to go. In the lane, Tommy Best forces it up. He got fouled on the play.
The move against Fordham that's so tough against their man-for-man is to get that ball in on the broken circle. It's considerably easier to make that entry pass against the zone.
14:44 to go. Correction on the time I gave you a little earlier. 14:44 left.
A little confusion there. Fordham thought there was a timeout.
Mike Cooper back in the game. The senior forward from the Bronx replaces David Maxwell.
Winner of this game has to come right back tomorrow at 1 o'clock and play for the championship.
Tommy Best has 9 points. Best is a 66% foul shooter. He's 5 for 6 from the line. And that one spins out. 7 point Fordham lead. McIntosh, good looking guard. Murphy against Gibbs. St. Peter's still man-to-man. McIntosh against Murray. Double team by Jamison. Murphy outside. What a touch. Murphy is 6 for 8.
All he needs is a little time. Excellent standing shooter.
12 points for Mark Murphy. Senior from Manchester, Connecticut. Down low, it's Anthony Green. Gives it off to Best. Best has been in the lane a long time. Best with his own rebound. And he banged it in off the glass. Roberson for Fordham couldn't believe it. Shaking his head at Ed Cartato. 43-36, Fordham by seven. 13:45 to go, second half. This is McIntosh taking it, and he's making it. Fordham shooting extremely well in the second half. McIntosh has hit three in a row. 9-point Fordham lead.
Tom Pender's up, waving his arms, imploring his team to get active with that defense.
45-38. Tommy Best now has 13 points.
And in truth, it's not much of a defense. St. Peter's is taking the Fordham zone apart right now.
McIntosh spins against Gibbs. This is Murphy. Now it's Roberson. Murphy against Murray. Banks it. A little too hard. Rebound, Will Jamison. Lead for Shelton Gibbs. Goes in against Murphy. Bad shot. Tried the finger roll. It lost control. Here comes McIntosh. And now he slows it up once again.
That's guard play, folks. A lot of guards get out there going fast, and they think when they get up at that speed, they've got to go all the way, showing excellent judgment.
Going baseline, blocking foul is called on Jamison. Tom Penders likes that call. First team foul by St. Peter's. Jamison called on the personal. 45-38, Fordham by 7. From the Burn Meadowlands Arena, this is college basketball.
Number 11 is Tony McIntosh, 6'2", sophomore, making his move.
McIntosh really playing well, having a good ball game. As we look at the Fordham huddle, Jerry Hobby, number 15. And there is Mark Murphy, the senior from Manchester, Connecticut, having a good ball game. He scored 12 already, and that's the fifth time in the last six games he's hit double figures. Started off the season shooting poorly and has really gotten his game together late in the season.
He's one of those players, though, that needs a McIntosh next to him. He needs a penetrator and a creator. He really doesn't do much for himself. A good standing jump shooter at 20 feet needs room.
There's Murphy, and again he hits. Murphy, three in a row in the second half.
Well-conceived out-of-bounds play pays off. Some finals in the Sun Belt Conference Tournament. South Florida, 66. South Alabama, 59. Jacksonville, 63. Old Dominion, 59, and that's an upset. We saw Jacksonville in here earlier this year.
Fordham having a great second half shooting. They were 13 for 30 in the first half. They are 7 for 10 in the second half, shooting 50% for the game. Another St. Peter's turnover. That is number 13 for the Peacocks.
Just under 12 minutes. Remember now, there's no shot clock now, nor will there be at the end of the game. No three-point play.
And Fordham has not turned the ball over in the second half. Foul called. Jamison again. Fordham with a 9-point lead. And threatening to blow this one at wide open, Bucky.
Yeah, but they do it in a sneaky way, Sam. They just don't overpower you. They spread the floor. They take their time. You're behind a little bit. You take a few chances.
Hobby was in trouble with time running out, and he threw it away. There's a Fordham turnover. Murray to Jamison. Tommy Best. Jamison outside. Too long. Kratulis the follow. Kratulis back in, replacing Shelton Gibbs. 47-40 with 11:25 to go second half.
John Kratulis, Bob Duquette's first recruit, had an amazing stat in the first half. He had 5 steals. Pretty good for a 6'5 center who isn't a blazer.
Fordham by 7. Best knocked it away, went to Hobby, forced it, missed it, and St. Peter's comes down with it. And a foul on Cooper, and that's his fourth.
Oh, Tom Pender's eyes rolled up in the top of his head that time. He just didn't want that foul at all. Mike Cooper, who's quick, a hustler, better in the running game, just saw that ball, thought he could get it from behind, and he went elbow high instead of knee high. Occasionally you can make that play, but you got to come around low.
Tom Penders coached at Columbia before coming to Fordham.
Fine guard at Connecticut, Sam. Played for Fred Schaible there.
Cooper remains in the game for Fordham. He has four personal fouls. Fordham leading by seven, 10:45 to go, second half.
1-2-2 matchup now by the Rams, but it's packed in. Again, dedicated to cutting off that inside game.
Best, he's the man they look to for points. He missed it, followed by Best. Green with a rebound. Foul in the lane, it's on Roberson.
With Best, Petulis, and Green, that's as strong a front court as Bobby Duquette can put on the floor, and it's showing on that offensive board. We may see a counter by Fordham with that bigger, slower team in there for St. Peter's. He may opt to his spread game and try to move them out, get them out of the color there, spread them across the court defensively.
6'10" Goran Skoko replaces Mike Cooper. Cooper, the senior forward, who played at DeWitt Clinton High School and has had his best year at Fordham. He's a four-year letterman. Green at the line is 2-for-2 and makes the first.
A lot of action on that free throw. He has a good backspin on it, but he was moving away before he released it. Let's see if he stays in there on this one.
Anthony Green, a junior from Queens, New York, went to Bayside High School and bounced out. Tommy Best, he's fouled. And suddenly St. Peter's doing an excellent job on the board, and they are closing in on Fordham.
Bobby Duquette's counter to go with his big front line. Big by some college standards. It's not awesome, but for this league, it's very competitive, and they are really working the glass. And Skoko's big body may make a difference.
With 10:27 to go in the second half, Fordham is already over the limit in fouls. St. Peter's with just two. Tommy Best, who has four offensive rebounds in this game. Strong player. Best, second one misses. 5-point Fordham lead.
It's interesting to watch free throw shooters and how many of them are too anxious to move their feet and their head before that ball's had a chance to go through. They should be staying right in that position until it hits.
St. Peter's a man-to-man defense. Murray against Murphy. Murphy number 10, down low. Roberson missed. Now Fordham on the boards. McCormick puts it in.
A little offensive rebounding by the Rams that time.
And I'll tell you, the big guy Skoko helped out, keeping the ball alive, along with Roberson. Pretulis. And a foul underneath. It's on Fordham, and this will be 1-1 at the line for St. Peter's. Don McCormick, a freshman. Glen Ridge, New Jersey, committed the foul.
Tom Pender still hasn't sold that sport coat. It's a pink slip sale.
Tommy Pender's in his fifth season at Fordham, his 12th year as a head coach in college basketball.
1981, he was the New York area Metro Coach of the Year. Coached for a while at Tufts.
Yep.
Tufts.
Did a good job there, went to Columbia, fine job at Columbia, and then now at Fordham, and has a contract through 1986.
Whoa, we got a lot of long-termers out there, huh?
There is a timeout on the floor. Fordham 49, St. Peter's 44, 9:45 left in the second half.
If you'd like to find a better way to fly on business, TWA has news for you. On most airlines, you don't have the comfort of a special business section. But on every TWA widebody, you'll find wider seats and fewer of them in a separate business class. It's TWA's Ambassador Class, and it's roomy and comfortable.
Even if you're next to someone as big as I am, you are.
Who's gonna like us? TWA.
Early each morning, dedicated professionals put together New York's top radio show.
Call from Miss Diamond.
Like newsman Charles McCord gathering the big story. Like Roz Frank with the traffic reports. And it takes a sensitivity to today's musical tastes.
and, of course, the consummate professional, Imus in the Morning.
Here he is, gang, the big star.
In short, to be New York's number one radio show.
WNBC.
You've got to be committed.
This is a good time to start thinking about season tickets for college basketball at the Burn Meadowlands Arena for next season. Great national matchups. There'll be NCAA regional basketball here. For ticket information, write College Basketball, Post Office Box 512, East Rutherford, New Jersey, or call 201-935-3900. And we look forward to bringing you more college basketball from the Burn Meadowlands Arena on Madison Square Garden Cablevision next season. It's been a pleasure working with the fine people here at the Meadowlands Arena this year. They've been extremely cordial and helpful throughout our college basketball coverage.
When I think about the absence of Ed Bona, who would have been the center for Fordham, I think about Dude Tongol, a seven-footer and a cousin of Bona who preceded him at Fordham. He's over there playing in the Sudan, and he's not playing for Lou Rossini, but Lou Rossini is still coaching over in that part of the world, the former NYU and St. Francis coach. You wonder what keeps guys like that going. You gotta love it.
Fordham, a tough man-to-man now by St. Peter's.
Boy, is it. I don't know what Bobby Duquette said in that timeout, but it did energize them.
McIntosh lost the ball. Tommy Penders can't believe it, but it's a turnover for Fordham. And with 9:24 to go in the second half, St. Peter's trailing by five. Trying to creep a little bit closer. Fordham with 12 turnovers in the game.
Maxwell's been out a long time for Fordham.
Gibbs also sitting down for St. Peter's.
I think that's been the interesting point in this game. The two franchise players we expected to carry their respective teams, because the foul trouble really haven't been that big a factor.
St. Peter's came into this game with a record of 22-4. Kratulis with the little set shot from outside.
You're not old enough to remember this, but it looks like Easy Ed McCauley with that soft one-handed stab.
I remember Easy Ed. That wasn't...
I gave you a chance. I gave you a chance to cut off 10 years.
Well, I used to watch films of them. And now it is down to three. Fordham 49, St. Peter's 46. McIntosh down low. McCormick on the ball. Jump ball. The arrow points Fordham's way.
Interesting now. It's Fordham in the zone and a passive zone at that. And it's St. Peter's in a very aggressive man for man. All right, here's the entry pass. Now, St. Peter's in a tough man for man. John Kratulis, number 50, goes up straight. Here comes help from the weak side. Green coming across to rattle the board. Good call by Larry Limbo.
Back live, Mark Murphy takes the short jump and got the roll. 51-46. Murphy having a fine game. He now has 16 points.
Boy, you talk about
missing the second half.
Coming through, Murphy and McIntosh.
And it's Fordham ball. Fordham by five, 51-46. Murphy is 4-for-6 in the second half, 8-for-12 in the game. Shelton Gibbs comes back in for St. Peter's.
Let's see if Tom Penders counters with David Maxwell.
Again, pressure for St. Peter's all over the floor.
Anthony Green, very agile at 6'6", number 34 for St. Peter's. Had knee problems last year. I'm impressed with the way he's playing the D.
Look at Jamison hounding McIntosh, Cooper to Murphy. Murphy's been the point getter for Fordham.
Well, if you're going to play man for man against Fordham, the time to do it is when Maxwell's not in there, because he's most effective with a one-on-one isolates.
Here's Shelton Gibbs for St. Peter's. Finds Tommy Besney foul. It's McCormick on the foul, and Best will go to the line with St. Peter's trailing by five, 7:35 to go, and a chance to move closer. Hobby comes back in. Jerry Hobby, the sophomore from Elizabeth, New Jersey. He was an all-state performer in high school and then went on to Frederick Military Academy before coming to Fordham. There's Tommy Best on the line. He's got 14.
Let's see if he stays in the shot this time. Don McCormick, number 44, the 6'5 freshman from Glen Ridge, New Jersey. Very physical player. I played in college with a player from that area. They're almost identical. His name was Tom Hopper. Played at North Carolina State. Came out of the Marine Corps. And he gave us all a lesson every day. karate and hand-to-hand combat. We almost couldn't wait for the games.
Fordham has called a timeout, 7:35 to go second half. It's Fordham 51, St. Peter's 47, and you're watching college basketball on Madison Square Garden Cablevision. And Bucky Waters and Bruce Beck at the Burn Meadowlands Arena. And Bucky, foul shooting is suddenly keeping St. Peter's in the game. In the second half, St. Peter's has scored 6 points from the foul line. Fordham has not gone to the line at all. Fordham is over the foul limit and has been for the last 3 minutes. St. Peter's only two team fouls. It could be a big factor come the end of the game.
And the irony of all that, and you're absolutely right, Sam Rosen, is that it is St. Peter's who is playing a very aggressive man for man, and they have given up only two fouls. Fordham, uncharacteristically in a rather passive zone, as you have pointed out, is the one that's piling up all of the personals. Bob Duquette trying to find a way to beat Fordham. Has not done very well. Five of the last six, the Rams have won both previous encounters this year.
Four seasons at St. Peter's for Bob Duquette, all winning seasons. Tommy Best makes the second. Best is now 8-for-11 from the foul line. And again, pressure from St. Peter's, 4-by-3, 51-48. 7.5 minutes to go, second half. Maxwell still sitting on the bench for Fordham. Shelton Gibbs is back in. He's guarding Jerry Hobby. This is McIntosh against Jameson. That's a tough matchup. McIntosh, the sophomore. McCormick against Kratulis. Hobby and Gibbs. Hobby to the basket. Downloads McIntosh. In some trouble. Three men around him. Gets rid of it. McCormick lost it. Saved by Hobby. And knocked away by Kratulis. Couldn't keep it in.
St. Peter, I've never seen him play that good of man-for-man defense. We've seen him three times this year for this sustained period. They just stayed right after. Watch him pivoting around now. He's being double-teamed. He tucks the ball under his chin, which is a smart play, giving you no chance to get on top of it. He is now triple-teamed, slides a little baseline pass. It was errant for a while. Fordham gets it back.
Here's Jerry Hobby against Jim Murray. Down low, foul call. It's on Anthony Green. Fouled Roberson. A non-shooting foul, 6:42 to go, third team foul. Ed Cartato making the call. Mark Murphy back in for Fordham, replaces Don McCormick. John Kratulis comes back in, replacing Jim Murray. St. Peter's has used just six players in the game.
Yeah, we're talking about Anthony Green. I'm impressed with his defense. He put some points on the board this year. He had 18 points and 8 rebounds against Fairfield just about a month ago.
Here's Murphy with a good move, but he missed it. And Green the rebound. He's got the long arms. And St. Peter's with a chance to come within one. It's been a while since they've been this close. Fordham led by 6.5. Best. Fordham had a 9-point lead, a chance to make it 11. They turned the ball over. St. Peter's has gotten closer. Jameson out of his range. Best with a follow. Tommy Best taking charge. Now has 18 points. What a game for Tommy Best coming through in the clutch.
It appears now that Fordham has lost the momentum. One of the options Penders has is to bring his team out and spread as he did at the end of the first half, and he did so successfully against Notre Dame. He can only do it while he's got the lead. And I think he's probably giving that a lot of thought right now. Old momentum is wearing a dark blue jersey.
As Tommy Pender's checking things out. Tommy Best went for the steal on that last play and committed the foul, non-shooting foul. And David Maxwell comes back in for Fordham, replacing Jerry Hobby, the senior from New York, went to Power Memorial High School. Roberson outside. Maxwell against Kratulis. 51-50, Fordham leads at 5:50 to go second half. The winner to the championship game tomorrow afternoon. Maxwell with a move, he missed it. Cooper couldn't get the rebound, Kratulis took it. Here comes St. Peter's, a chance to regain the lead for the first time since midway through the first half.
Maxwell looked up and saw John Kratulis, and he knew where he was going. He blew right by him, had it all the way, just missed the layup.
Patience for St. Peter's. Jamison looking. Shelton Gibbs just floating around down the baseline. Tommy Best being denied the ball by Roberson. Bad pass and a steal by Cooper for Fordham. Remember that turnover. 5:10 to go. Second half. Fordham by one. McIntosh against Jamison.
There's the spread. A good move by Penders. Seeing that the momentum got away from his team, he's going to let St. Peter's work on defense for a little while. They got all that energy. They got things going their way. Let's let them chase for a while.
Fordham beat St. Peter's 67-52 the first time they met. And that was at St. Peter's, then at Madison Square Garden. Fordham won it by four. And now in the semifinals of the MAC Conference Tournament, Maxwell had an idea to shoot, took it back outside.
Well, with 4 minutes and 20 seconds to go, it's too long to hold it. Oh, I didn't hear that whistle. I thought he'd thrown it out of bounds. They've got to keep looking for the basket, and they do. They do it very well.
It's Tommy Best on the foul, and that is his fourth. And now suddenly Tommy Best becomes a very important man for St. Peter's because he has been the hub of their offense in the second half.
Cooper has four. David Maxwell has four for Fordham.
Murphy into Maxwell. Against Best, he gets around him. Maxwell goes outside, almost lost it.
Fordham has to be definite. They either have to pull him out and go ahead and get in their control game. Right now, they're about halfway.
Roberson to Cooper. He shot it. 53-50. 4 minutes to go. Fordham leads it by three.
I have a little prejudice against those finger rolls. I think they're lousy shots. I didn't like them when Chamberlain shot them. If you're in there, put the ball on the board and don't just roll it up there with a lot of spin.
Chamberlain just shot him straight down. That's
yeah,
all.
Yeah, but he should have done that more. He missed a lot of those finger rolls. You get up there above the rim, that's no time to be cute.
Hammer it. 3:52 to go, second half. Fordham by three. We'll be back in just a moment.
SMA's gigantic inventory clearance sale, up to 60% or more off. Magnificent diamond solitaires, 1 carat ovals, $3.95, 1.5 carat rounds, $4.95. Gorgeous diamond stud earrings, 0.5 carat, $1.50, 1 carat, $2.99, 2 carat, $6.95. Exquisite diamond cluster rings, all 1 carat total weight, $2.95 each. Fantastic diamond solitaires, 2 carat marquees, $9.95, 3 carat pairs, $15.95.
Who deserves a diamond from SMA?
Six great locations.
Race to the bottom?
Not all the way.
For Michelob Light?
You're on.
Michelob Light for the winner.
Would good friends go at it this hard for a beer? Well, it is Michelob Light, a rich, smooth taste you can compare to any beer you like.
Michelob Light for the winner.
Where'd you ever learn to ski like that anyway?
Houston.
Michelob Light.
Sam Rosen, Bucky Waters, Bruce Beck at the Burn Meadowlands Arena. Fordham with a three-point lead. It was one at this point.
Fordham trying to spread the floor a little bit. Dave Roberson goes inside, a nice feed. Cooper coming down is challenged by Green. The little finger roll hits the board, hits the rim, drops through. Both teams a little indecisive right there. St. Peter's not really clear on how much pressure they were in, whether they were trapped, whether they were man for man. They were kind of hanging back. and probably Fordham shouldn't have taken the ball in there until they had really committed their opponent.
Fordham by 3, 53-50. St. Peter's, second half, shooting 8 for 17 from the floor. Fordham improving the shooting, 10 for 18 from the floor in the second half. Jamison and Murray working the backcourt for St. Peter's.
Fordham kept St. Peter's on defense a long time with that scheme of the spread. Let's see whether or not that affects their offense. They were red hot. Fordham now man for man.
St. Peter's 7 for 11 from the foul line in the second half. Fordham has not gone to the foul line in the second half. We have 3:25 to go. Murray.
Interesting matchup there. David Maxwell is playing Jim Murray, who is not much of a threat for drawing that fifth foul.
Trying to find Sean Gibbs. They can't do it. Now it's Anthony Green on the turnaround. He put it in. 6'6" Anthony Green, the junior. Putting it in. It's down to one again.
Sheldon Gibbs also working on Tony McIntosh inside. McIntosh giving away a few inches is being posted. St. Peter's in a half court. 1-2-1-1 trap.
Cooper comes back outside with it. 2:50 to go. Fordham by one. Cooper, McIntosh up and good. Pretty shot by the sophomore Tony McIntosh. 55-52, 2:35 to go.
Boy, he earned that one. He switched it over in the left hand and just did escape the reject.
McIntosh has hit 5 in a row. 3-point lead. Down low for Best, a little too far. It hit the rim, and Murphy has it for Fordham. A big turnover.
Lots of time left. 2 minutes, 15 seconds, a 3-point pad. This time, still a half-court trap.
There's
no,
McIntosh.
I'm sorry. They're playing a little run and jump off the man for man.
Roberson, baseline is foul underneath. Anthony Green called on the foul.
I can only guess, Sam, but I think Tom Penders is talking now to Mark Murphy in the backcourt. I think he'd like to run a little time off, not so much to preserve the lead. I think he wants to keep St. Peter's on the D a little bit longer, make them chase. So far, Fordham is going for the basket very quickly, and in doing so, they're really not set up in a half-court offensive attack. They don't have much offensive board power. I think he'd like for St. Peter's to chase a little bit, really pull them out tight all the way around, try to get the back door of the easy layup.
Roberson, a 55% foul shooter for 2. That one went swish.
Nice release. You know, you look at those forearms and biceps, and you watch the delicate release. You've got to be impressed.
6 points for Roberson in the game. 4-point Fordham lead. And it's 5, 57-52, 2:06 to go.
In the NIT this year, with that multicolored red, white, blue ball, we'll be able to see the rotation on the shooters.
Bertulis outside. Jamison, long jumper is too long. And the rebound to Cooper. Cooper breaks out of the pack. The lead for Maxwell slows it down. Good move for Fordham. They're up by 5. They can kill some time here. St. Peter's needs the ball. McIntosh. Fordham benches up. Roberson to the hoop. He's fouled.
This is what Penders wanted. He wants to spread St. Peter's out, make them a little antsy. When you have to work that hard and chase a little bit, what happens is when you get the ball and you go to the other end, you get a little too anxious. And that's what's happened the last 2 times down the floor. What was a red-hot St. Peter's offense got very antsy, had some key turnovers. So simply by spreading the defense, Tom Penders helped to diffuse the momentum a little bit.
St. Peter's has called timeout with 1:30 to go. And the Fordham Rams with a 5-point lead, looking for their 3rd straight win over St. Peter's this season. Looking for the win that will take them into the championship game against the winner of the game between Iona and Army.
You know, David Maxwell is out in front in that last series down the floor. And in his freshman and sophomore year, he would have taken that ball to the basket, probably made a forced play. Here's McIntosh in charge, trying to spread the defense, really not penetrating, running a little time, making St. Peter's chase. Now he makes the turn, comes into the paint, good bounce pass. Dave Robertson probably shouldn't have gone for the hoop. He didn't have the unmolested shot, took his beating. Still, I think Tom Penders would like to see Fordham even more definite and not taking that ball in there when the shot's going to be contested.
Hard to figure Fordham winning a game when Maxwell is held to just 6 points, but credit Tony McIntosh, the sophomore from New Jersey, having an outstanding game. He's got 14. Tom Penders.
He's also created well for Mark Murphy. McIntosh, in my book, no question about it. He would have to be the player of the game if we were picking one. But Bob Duquette's got a minute.
You can pick one, Bucky. Go ahead.
Can I pick one?
Yeah.
What are we going to give him? You want to give him a car or a weekend in Philadelphia? What are you going to give him?
I give him 2 Bucky Waters autographs.
Yeah.
Roberson at the line. He's played a strong game inside. He's only 6'5". Neither team very big, as we mentioned. 6-point lead. 5 points in a row for Fordham. St. Peter's got within one twice. One time they had a chance to take the lead and they turned the ball over.
Look for him to go to Sheldon Gibbs, especially if McIntosh is guarding him. That's where the mismatch is.
Roberson missed the second one. 58-52. A minute 25.
Gibbs posting up with McIntosh down underneath. He wants to isolate. They
now
got him.
Missed it. And the rebound for them. And a big rebound by McIntosh.
Everything was by the game plan except the shot didn't go.
Here's Tony McIntosh. David Maxwell. Roberson foul. And it'll be 1-1 at the line for Fordham. Well, the Rams hadn't gone to the line for about 17 and a half minutes of the second half, and suddenly Roberson is making a second home of it there.
Well, he's only a 51% free throw shooter on the season, so he's a good percentage, but I swear the stroke looks good.
Roberson, 4-for-6 from the line. He's got a nice spin on the ball, nice follow through.
Yeah.
And he's hitting in the clutch. And he has helped Fordham open it up to 7. A minute 5 to go, and the Rams will be in the championship game tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock here at the Burn Meadowlands Arena.
Whoa, hey, Sam, there's a minute 5 seconds to go. Come on, don't give it away yet.
All right, it's 8 points. It looks pretty good. Jamison down low, missed it. And St. Peter's has been unable to come up with a big bucket in the last 2.5 minutes.
Well, you're looking better. But that was 2 easy shots they missed the last time down the floor. Both of them could have been for 3.
40 seconds left, foul.
That should be 2.
And it is. Larry Lembo calls it 2-shot foul.
A frustrated foul by Jamison that time. Phil Jamison really did make an effort for the ball. Mostly because Mark Murphy turned his back.
Look at the Fordham bench. Howie Evans, the assistant coach, was punching the air. There are the players. The big guy is Goran Skoko from Yugoslavia. Murphy at the line. He's had an excellent ball game. 17 points, his first free throw. He's had a good game, hitting 8-for-12 from the floor. The senior, Mark Murphy, went to East Catholic High School in Manchester, Connecticut. He makes both. 40 seconds to go. Fordham with its biggest lead of the game. They've hit 9 points in a row. It is 62-52. Murray, they've got to get it up in a hurry. For best, it's knocked away and stolen. Here comes Maxwell. Cooper with him. Cooper to the hoop. He fouled. Murray fouled him. Good break by Fordham. Nice pass from Maxwell to Cooper. And the victory high fives are being given all around. The Fordham Rams have clinched victory here. They are putting this one away. And Bob Duquette will have only lost his 5th game of the season. Not a happy man. It's been a great season for St. Peter's and for Bob Duquette. They'll have lost 5 games all season and 3 of them to Fordham. They've lost 1 to Iona and 1 to Arkansas. Mike Cooper, the senior from the Bronx, who's had his best season in 4 at Fordham, hit both 64-52. 11 straight points for Fordham to put this game away. Murray knocked away and stolen by Maxwell. He goes in. Two more. 20 seconds to go. What a finish by the Fordham Rams. They had gone up by nine early in the second half. St. Peter's got to within one twice. Tommy Best missed it. Another miss on the follow by Gibbs. St. Peter's has been unable to score in the last 4 or 5 minutes. The last shot of the game, no basket. It is waved off. Basket does not count. Mike Cooper goes off, the senior. One of the fine players for Fordham in this ball game. But the Fordham Rams, in the last 2.5, 3 minutes, running 11 straight points, make that 13 points in a row as they defeat St. Peter's in the semifinals here, 66-52. An outstanding game for the Fordham Rams, and they move into the championship round. They'll play the winner of Iona and Army. So Fordham wins.